That brings us to a new coherence protocol, which is multiple rider protocol. So the idea is we want to maintain coherence information still at the granularity of pages, because that is the granularity at which the operating system operates, and therefore the DSM can be integrated with the operating system if the granularity of coherence maintenance is at the level of a page. But at the same time, we want to allow multiple writers to be able to write to the same page, recognizing that an application programmer may have packed lots of different data structures within the same page. So we're going to see how this multiple writer coherence protocol works. And in particular, we're going to use that in concert with lazy release consistency. The background for what I'm going to describe is covered in the paper that is assigned for you, which is the trademarks paper. I encourage you to read that paper to get all the details, but here I'm going to give you a high-level view of how LRC is integrated with multiple writer protocol in the trademark system. So a processor P1 acquires a lock and makes modifications. This notation that I'm using is to indicate that these pages, X, Y, and Z, actually, they are data structures that are being modified, but we are maintaining coherence at the level of pages. So we will say that the data structures that we're modifying within this critical section are contained in pages X, Y, and Z. And so those are the pages that are being modified within this critical section when processor P1 executes this piece of code. Now, the operating system has no knowledge of the association between this lock L and the pages that are being modified. All it knows is that within the critical section, these are the pages that were modified. That's what the operating system knows. And what we're going to do is we're going to create a diff of the changes that were made to the pages X, Y, and Z in this critical section. So we know at the beginning of this critical section what the contents of the page X, Y, and Z is. And at the end of this critical section, we're going to find out what is the difference that has been made, or what are the changes that have been made, and compute the diffs between the original page and the modified page. XD, YD, and ZD are the diffs to pages X, Y, and Z respectively as a result of executing this critical section. So the coherence protocol we're going to use is LRC, or lazy release consistency. So the next time the same lock L is requested by some other processor P2, we're going to first invalidate the pages we know were modified by the previous lock holder, because this is information that is available to the DSM, that at the point of unlock, it knows that these were the pages that were modified by this critical section. It doesn't know what part of the pages were modified that's contained in the diffs, but it knows that pages X, Y, and Z are associated with this lock L. And therefore, when P2 makes this lock request L, the DSM is going to first invalidate if copies of pages X, Y, and Z are locally resident in the processor P2, then the DSM software is going to invalidate those pages X, Y, and Z at the point of lock acquisition. That's consistent with the lazy release consistency model. So once we've invalidated these pages, then you can allow this guy to get the lock and start getting into its critical section. Now, once it is in the critical section, it can do whatever it wants. But if it tries to access page X, at that point, we know that page is invalid because we've done that at the beginning of this critical section, invalidated page X. And at this point, the DSM software also knows that the previous lock holder has the modifications that need to be made to the original page to get the current version of the page. The current version of the page is with some owner for this page. I mentioned this ownership-based protocol in the DSM software. So the DSM software knows who the owner of the page is. From the owner of the page, I can get the original content of X. I'll do that. But I'll also go and get the diff that was created by the execution of the previous critical section by the previous lock holder. So the DSM software brings, at the point of access to X, XD, and the original version of the page from the owner of the page. It can then create the current version of the page for use by P2.